Hello everybody, this is Angie, and I have two mini albums that I made quite some time ago, probably a few months ago, and they've been sitting on my craft shelf for all that time, but I've never done a review on them, and I'm going to go ahead and do that now. But I also want to say, if you like what you see, stay tuned because I have a surprise announcement at the end. Okay, First, I will go through the pink one because this is the one that's more completed. The other one will give room for additional things. But first of all, I used, and I love this. I wish Michaels would come back with more wood birdcage pieces like this. But this was from Michaels. I put some pearls here to get it more bling. This is a wood piece that I stamped with two stamps and put a little glossy accents or something there to give it some more bling. I added a dangle charm on the side, which has a heart, a couple of charms, a bird charm, and this is one of those glass charms from Hobby Lobby where you can make a charm, and that's a little fairy there. So every page has pockets. And I did a lot of stamping, which I usually hardly ever do, but I just got into a stamping mood. And all of these stamps I've been having like forever. They're extremely feminine. So that's the first pocket. And they're also quite original because I forget what web page I bought them from. But here's a very, very different dress form stamp, and as I said before, all of them have pockets, so there's a pocket back here. And we have so much that sometimes it's hard to turn the page. This is one of my favorite images of a very beautiful lady. I got a lot of vintage, actually antique images on a CD from eBay, and I use this one a lot. And here's an envelope. I'm not going to take it undone. It's just an envelope in here. And I added tags in a lot of these pockets with some seam binding. Here's another pocket or envelope. And there's a lot of embossing here. On the cover of the envelope, on this page with a fairy. Here's another tag if you want to use it or if somebody wants to use it. Another embossed envelope. Another embossed sheet with the word inspire. So I think there's a tag in here. Yeah, it's a smaller tag. Another dress form, a little bit different. There's a tag in here with a charm. Oh, yeah, I stamped this one. Multiple stamps. And here's a piece of the Graphic 45 Once Upon a Time cardstock. I love this paper because it's already sparkly. I don't know if you can see that sparkle. But anyway, here's the last page with another Graphic 45 fairy. And that's a pocket, and that's the last page. And that is the pink mini album. I hope it stands up. They've been standing up forever until I decide to do a review. Okay, now this is a lavender. I do love lavender, but this one turned out the paper was a little bit darker. A same front. Birdcage stamped and blinged out tag. I have a different charm, dangle charm here. It's a tiny birdcage. The word joy, a pearl, a wing, and another glass charm with a different fairy on it. This one doesn't contain quite as many pockets, but there's the, and this is a mini version of the other stamp that I did with the dress form. This one has butterflies. Isn't that sweet? Again, all pockets and some tags in there. This is, again, another envelope that I don't know if you could see it because it's cream on cream, that I embossed the top for. I found this really lovely sign from the Graphic Fairy here on here online, and I just love her antique signs and things. Another envelope with some seam binding. All of these have a lot of seam binding on them. Marie Antoinette stamp. And a tag in here if you want to write something. Another pastisserie, I think that's the way you say it. Stamp or image. Okay, and this one I left blank in case a person wants to put something on there. Here's a binder clip with another area that's left clear. Another image from the Graphic Fairy that I just printed out and put it on the page. Another envelope. This one is left more clear for additional stamping and whatever, you know, the recipient might want to do. And that ends that one. This one is a bit shorter, but it's lavender. Now, I've gone through both of them. Here is my announcement. I am going to give away one of these. And it will be the winner's choice, either the pink or the lavender. Today is Thursday. I believe it's August the 11th. I will double check. I will make I will select a winner. Next Friday, I will put the date up here. Next Friday, I will select a winner from the people who make comments. Only one comment per person, please, and you must be a subscriber. If you're not a subscriber, go back to my main page, and you'll see a red button. That means you're not subscribed. Click on that. You're subscribed, then come back and make a comment, because please believe me, if I pick a name, I will check my subscribers list. If you're not there, I will go to the next name. I will select somebody else. So, again, be a subscriber. Make a comment, and only one comment per person. In your comment, state whether you want the pink or the lavender, and the winner will get the one of his or her or his choice. So, let's see. Oh, yeah, if you have any, well, I can't tell you, please feel free to jot them down there because that's going to be your entry. Well, you could message me if you have any comments. You could just go to my page. There's a little section that says about, and then you click on that and you can message me for any questions, because if you write them down there, then that's going to be your entry. And you could do that and still select a color. But anyway, I'm rattling on. Pink or lavender, you must be a subscriber. Selection will be next Friday, and I'll put the selection date up there. So, good luck to everybody. Let's see. Oh, yeah. I am wishing you all a wonderful creative day. Bye now.